help to increase the production. So there is a non-linear relation. Linear relations means constant growth is there. There is a constant growth. But in non-linear, there is no constant growth. After a certain point, it takes an asymptote. So relation may be either linear or non-linear. But for simplicity, the linear relationship is more popular in the non-statistician to find out the relationship between two variables. But we can find non-linear correlation between or non-linear regression between two variables. But for this, we have to learn these things also. The formula for this non-linear regression and non-linear correlation are a little bit complex than the linear relationship. So here we can, here we are only talk about the linear relationship between two variables, okay? So one thing I'd like to know, everybody is comfortable with English or somebody or not, so that I can use Hindi also. Dharan said me to some are not comfortable with the English. If anybody are not understanding all this English version, so they can raise question. I can explain it in the Hindi. Is it? So before developing the any methodology, there should be some assumption. We cannot violate these assumptions. If we violate these assumptions, we have a wrong result, and then further we are inferring wrongly. So we are talking about the linear relationship between two variables. So what are the assumptions? The sample of paired data. There are two variables, variable X and variable Y. So there are two variables. One first name is X and second name is Y. And there are some observations. I am talking about the paired data. Paired data means the number of observations in X, first variable, is same as the number of observations of second variable. Means there is a pair of data. One observation in X must have the observation for Y. Is a random sample. Is a random sample. Means the pair of data of two variables should be random. And the data taken from the normal population. It is very difficult to explain for the non-statistician, what is the normal population? Just imagine, suppose you are asking your friend or your family member in a different city during this time, what is your question? Kya bhai, kaisi situation hai? Samne wale ka kya jawab aata hai? Arre yaar, normal nahi hai. Ya normal hai. Aisa kuch aata hai jawab na? To normal ka matlab kya hota hai? For a layman, what is the meaning of normal? The normal means everything is okay. Everything is going in the proper manner. तो वही चीज है कहने का मतलब कि normal population से लिया हुआ होना चाहिए. Normal होगा तो जाता है, नहीं होता है तो नहीं जाता है. Normal है, abnormal position है, यानी curfew लगी है, कुछ corona बढ़ा है, ये वो कुछ ऐसा disease propagation है. So the pair of observations should be taken from the normal population. Definition. Scatter diagram. What is a scatter diagram? A scatter diagram is a graph in which the pair of variables are plotted on x-axis, the variable X, and on y-axis, the variable Y. So each of individual pair is plotted on a single point. With this plot, you can also decide whether the what type of correlation is there. So in this figure, you can see the points are in the 45% with the 45% degree with the x-axis. means there is a direction. This direction is what? This is the positive coordinates. So this direction is a positive. So there may be positive correlation. Next figure. This first figure provide the positive correlation. This is a strong positive and this is perfect positive. Means all the points, all the pair of points on the same line. So with the help of a scatter diagram, you can get how much, you can have idea about how much, but not exactly. You can say there is a strong, there is moderately strong, there is mild strong, there is strongly negative correlation between the variables. In this, the first graph shows the negative correlation, second is strong negative, and third, perfect negative. But they cannot say the correlation coefficient is equal to 0.95 or 0.75 or 0.45 or 0.2. It can only be obtained with the formula. Next picture, there is no correlation. Very scattered, all the points have, there is no pattern. So there is no correlation. In this, there is a pattern, but this is not linear. Half of the positive and half of the negative. So either we can use piecewise regression or something else that is not up to your, that is not for useful for you. So this is the nonlinear correlation. So when I am talking this fertilizer use, once fertilizer using, the production is increasing. After that, they destroy the crops and your production will become zero. So this is the correlation coefficient, which is represented by a small r. And this is the formula for correlation coefficient. And this measure the strength of linear relationship between variable X and Y. Be careful. I am talking about linear relationship. This is not non-linear relationship. There are different formula that is known as correlation ratio. This is correlation coefficient. This is relationship between strength of relationship in quantitative form of linear relationship between two variables X and Y. So what is this? This is R is equal to covariance, COV, covariance of X and Y. Covariance of X and Y. So it is not on the full screen. Now it is on the full screen. So covariance of XY, SD, this SDX and this is SDY. SDX is the standard deviation of variable X and SDY is the standard deviation of variable Y. So what SD tells? SD is the standard deviation of X and SDY is the standard deviation of Y. Means inner variability between the data set. And what is covariance? Covariance is the joint variability. Covariance provide the idea about the joint variability between X and Y. Is it clear? So see on this formula, you know, standard deviation is always positive. Standard deviation of variable is always positive. Why? Everybody is understanding with this. This is clear for everybody. The measure of variability is always positive. This is not negative. So variance is positive. Square root of this is also positive. So standard deviation of X is positive. Standard deviation of Y is positive. So the product is also positive. But I am discussing correlation may be negative, may be positive. So the positivity and negativity, or you can say the positive character and negative character of the correlation coefficient depending on only covariance of variables. So covariance may be positive, may be negative, When it is negative, the correlation coefficient is negative. When it is positive, correlation coefficient is positive. So sometime this correlation coefficient is known as standardized covariance. With the formula, it is very clear this covariance decide the positivity and negativity of the correlation, and it is somewhat standardized with the standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. So it is known as standardized covariance. So properties of the correlation coefficient, range of correlation coefficient is from -1 to 1. When it is -1, there is a perfect negative correlation. When it is equal to 1, there is a perfect positive correlation. Between these, there are so many negative and positive values. Accordingly, you can interpret your result. Between these, -1 and 1, there is a 0. Suppose you have data and you are going to find correlation coefficient and the answer is 0. What is your interpretation? You can't say there is no relation. There is relation. I'm talking prior. If the variable are not causally related, you can't think about the relational measure. So variables are related, but the linear correlation is absent. Linear correlation coefficient is equal to 0. It cannot say non-linear correlation is equal to 0. Be clear. Always in the examination, we ask the question, if r is equal to 0, what will be your interpretation? Okay. The relation between two variables is 0, then r is equal to 0. When r is equal to 0, we can't say the variables are dependent. Now you can say when the variables are depending, the correlation coefficient cannot be equal to 0. If the variables are independent, correlation coefficient is equal to 0. If correlation coefficient is equal to 0, we can't say the variables are independent. Variables are dependent because we are going to obtain the relation, measure of relation. Means we assume the variables are related, causally related. But here I'm talking about the linear correlation coefficient, and the linear correlation coefficient is equal to 0. Means the variables are not independent. Variables are linearly not dependent. They are non-linearly dependent. Value of r does not change if the values of either variable are converted to a different scale. So if we change the scale of variables, correlation coefficient does not change. Is it clear? Or you can say, if we change the origin, correlation coefficient does not change. Change the scale, correlation coefficient does not change. So man, if you want to get the value of correlation coefficient manually, then you can use this technique to reduce the observations, bigger observation in the smaller observation, so that mathematical complexity become less. The R, correlation coefficient, is not affected by the choice of X and Y. Interchange X and Y, the value of R will be not change. Okay, what does it mean? The correlation coefficient between X and Y is same as the correlation coefficient between Y and X. Is it clear? So correlation of X and Y is equal to correlation of Y and X. Common error involving the correlation. I have already talked Poisson and linearity. So Poisson, it is wrong to conduct that the correlation implies causality. Suppose there are two data set. I have discussed in the previous section the relationship between demand of electricity and availability of electricity. The data said, yes, there is correlation, but this correlation does not imply the causality, the causes. So first we establish the causality, then obtain the correlation. Don't obtain correlation and make it causal. First, you have to decide whether these variables are useful for obtaining correlation regression or all or not. If there is no causal relation, don't go for the correlation and regression. Linearity, there may be some relationship between X and Y even when there is no significant linear correlation. I am talking about this. If the correlation coefficient R is equal to 0, does not mean the variables are independent. They may be related non-linearly. So this is rank correlation. So the correlation coefficient is made for the quantitative variable. But many times we have quantitative variable or the variable which is in the rank. Suppose there are two judges in a sport and some players are there and they give some rank to them. My question is that what is the relation between the opinion of judges? So correlation coefficient does not give the answer. So in this situation, you can use rank correlation. So rank correlation is obtained through the formula of correlation coefficient. And this formula becomes 1 minus 6 sigma di square upon n into n square minus 1. Di is the difference between the ranks. And be careful, summation of di should be equal to 0. If this is not equal to 0, go to back and check it. So 6 sigma di square upon n into n square minus 1 subtracted from 1 provide the rank correlation. And again, the range of this rank correlation is minus 1 to 1. So rank correlation is represented by rho and Pearson's correlation coefficient is represented by R. So now rank correlation. So see, the expert given the rank HR, rank DI. So what is DI? DI is the difference between what? 10 and 8. This is 9 and 7. 7 and 3. So what is the sum of this? 4, 6, 3, 5, 0, 0. Is it clear? So sum should be equal to 0. So finally, DI square is equal to this. So summation, this rho is 1 minus this summation DI square, the sum of this is 51. Number of observation is 10. 10 square minus 1. So finally, the rank correlation is 0.648. Means the correlation is high between expert and HR specialist. This is Pearson correlation coefficient. Expert, HR, XY. This is the rank given by X. So summation of XI upon N, summation of XI upon N. These all are given and putting in this formula, we get this. R is equal to 0.6172. So the Pearson correlation coefficient for this data is 0.617 and with this rank correlation it is 0.642. So rank correlation formula which is given by this Pearman is little bit higher than the correlation coefficient given by Pearson's. But it is important to know when we have the data in real form, it is advisable to the use of Pearson correlation coefficient instead of Spearman rank correlation. Don't go for the ranking and then get this Pearson correlation coefficient. This is easier in computation than the Pearson correlation coefficient. Now look at this formula. Is there a significant linear correlation? So X is the plastic KZ and Y is the household. So this is the data for Garvis. So this is the correlation coefficient and graph. Now you're going to check this linear correlation is significant or not. So what is our hypothesis? Means correlation is equal to zero versus correlation is not equal to zero. Test statistics is this, critical value is this. You can see the critical value from the table and then compare it. So this 0.07, sorry, 707 is lesser than the calculated value. So what will be the interpretation? So 0.842 is greater than 0.707. That the test statistic does not fall within the critical region. Therefore, we reject null hypothesis and conclude there is a significant linear correlation between the weight of discarded plastic and household size. Means if this household size is bigger, the discarded plastic garbage is more. Now this is the test statistics. It is not noted. So correlation, for correlation coefficient, the test statistics is this. R is the correlation, 1 minus R square. R square is the square of correlation coefficient. And this is what? N minus 2. N minus 2. It is, suppose you transform this, it comes into the numerator. N minus 1 comes in the numerator. So if N is much, much more, your T value is become more and then it becomes significant. So for the bigger sample size, any smaller correlation coefficient is sometimes significant. And for the smaller number of sample size, the higher correlation coefficient does not significant. So be careful when you are going to test the correlation coefficients. So interpreting the correlation coefficient, if the absolute value of correlation coefficient exceed the value of significant table, conclude that there is a significant linear correlation. Otherwise, there is no sufficient evidence to support the correlation of significant linear correlation. And remember, N minus 2 is the level of, sorry, degree of freedom. So whole thing, the whole thing is depending on N. So this is a robust test for the testing correlation coefficient. So anything more you can ask for the correlation coefficient? So this correlation coefficient, which I have discussed here for the linear correlation, if you want to know non-linear correlation coefficient, then you can ask later on. So people are using this linear correlation. They assume the variables are linearly related and they go for the calculation. If you assume the variables are not linearly related, then there is a formula for correlation ratio that is complex for non-statistician or those who are weak mathematical background. So now this correlation coefficient tells only the relationship, the strength of relationship between two variables, means how much they are related. The relationship is very strong or not, whether this is positively strongly negative or not. So this only says the strength of relationship. But one question comes into mind: how much they affect a variable the another variable? Suppose what disturbance is there? Yes, this is good. So suppose a question comes into mind. Okay, I know how much the strength of correlation between two variables, but what is the effect of one variable on the another variable? Or you can say, if we want to change first variable, what is the effect of on its change on the second variable? It is also important to know. So it does not obtain through the correlation. So we need another measure that is known as regression. So regression is what? Regression is a mathematical structure between the two variables. Or you can say mathematical relation in terms of a function in a equation between the two variables. So the regression equation is y is equal to a plus bx. So what is a? A is the slope and b is the coefficient of x. So this is a algebraic relationship between the two variables, or you can say the definition of regression is an algebraic relationship between two variables given by y is equal to a plus bx. Suppose you have two variables. So what is it becomes? A plus b1x plus b2x. Regression line, line of best fit or least square. The graph of regression equation, I'm coming that point before this. I'd like to tell how to estimate A and B. The correlation coefficient formula is given, covariance of x and y divided by sdx into sdy. But here this is the algebraic relation between two variables y and x. So what is the meaning of this y and x? Y is equal to ax plus b. Here y is depending on x. So there may be an equation for x, x is equal to. So if x is depending on y, there is another equation. So as far as concerned the correlation of x and y is equal to correlation of y and x. But here the story is different. There is an equation for y and another for x. When y is depending on x, the regression equation is for y on x. And when x is depending on y, there is an equation which shows x is equal to something. So when you want to know the effect of x and y, you should use y is equal to a plus bx. When you want to know what is the effect of y on x, x is equal to a plus by. So this is the regression line. This passes from the mean of x and y. And there is a method of least square. With the help of this method of least square, you can get the value of a and b. Our purpose is to find out a and b. Until unless to find a and b, we cannot obtain the effect of x on y. So in this equation, see, y is equal to a plus x. Again disturbing.
Sorry, sir.
No, it is okay. So y is equal to a plus bx. B is the coefficient of x, and that is known as what? Regression coefficient. And a is what? Slope. Look at the equation. Suppose we have used x plus 1 in place of x. X plus 1 in place of x. So the newer equation becomes y is equal to a plus b x minus plus b. A, this x plus 1 instead of x. So it becomes bx plus b. And we know that a plus bx is y. So finally, this becomes y plus b. So if we change x by unity, y change by regression coefficient. So the, what is the interpretation of regression coefficient? Regression coefficient's interpretation is that if we change independent variable, that is x, by unity, then the dependent variable changed by regression coefficient. Means agar independent variable mein one unit aap change karoge, to dependent variable kitna change ho jayega? Regression coefficients usme add ho jayega. Clear? So this is the interpretation of regression coefficient. One more. What is the interpretation of this? Suppose x is equal to 0. X and y is the data taken from the normal population, and it is always what? It is always continuous. We should avoid it when it is discrete. Discrete means when it is ordinal or nominal, we should avoid. But always aap log ka jo data milta hai wo discrete form mein milta hai. Agar main age puchunga to koi aadmi apni age decimal mein nahi batayega. तो डेटा देख करके ये कहना है कि नहीं साहब ये डिस्क्रीट है या कंटिन्यूअस है, हम नहीं कह सकते. हम वेरिएबल के कैरेक्टर के ऊपर करेंगे. एज अगर वेरिएबल है तो वो कंटिन्यूअस होगा, क्योंकि एज कैन टेक एनी वैल्यू वेदर इट इज इन योर डेटा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिस्क्रीट सॉरी इंटीजर. सपोज एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, व्हाट इट बिकम्स? वाई इज इक्वल टू ए. So dependent variable is equal to A when x is equal to 0. Is it clear? Means this is the starting value of dependent variable. If there are two variable x and y, and you have the regression equation like y is equal to x plus b, a plus bx, x is equal to 0, means when independent variable is equal to 0, what is the value of y? It is equal to A. So EA is the starting value, or you can say it is the threshold value of y, or you can say this is the minimum value of y. So very interesting example I would like to share. Somebody government ke log kabhi kabhi baith karke aapko 30 rupaye mein khana bhi khila dete hain aur kuch bhi keh dete hain. AC mein baith ke sare decision nahi hote, they know little bit स्टैटिस्टिक्स. एंड एक समय की बात है जब लोगों ने कहा कि नहीं, कंट्रासेप्टिव यूज करके फर्टिलिटी को जीरो किया जा सकता है. डू यू बिलीव ये कंट्रासेप्टिव यूज 100% हो जाएगा और फर्टिलिटी आपकी रिड्यूस हो जाएगी? दे फाइंड आउट दिस रिलेशनशिप. उनके दो वेरिएबल थे, एक्स कंट्रासेप्टिव यूज, वाई नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन एवर बॉर्न, और फर्टिलिटी या कुछ भी कह लीजिए उसको. उन्होंने एक रिलेशन निकाला, और रिलेशन निकालने के बाद उन्होंने देखा, कहा कि साहब ये तो जीरो नहीं होगा, बिकॉज ए हैज सम वैल्यूज. तो आप कंट्रासेप्टिव कितना भी यूज कर लोगे, आपकी फर्टिलिटी जीरो नहीं होगी. वहां पे नेगेटिव रिलेशन आएगा ना, कंट्रासेप्टिव यूज करेंगे तो फर्टिलिटी घटती है, तो ए माइनस समथिंग आएगा. रेग्रेशन कोएफिशिएंट उसका नेगेटिव आएगा, क्योंकि कोरिलेशन नेगेटिव होगा उनके बीच में. ए माइनस समथिंग आया, उन्होंने कहा कि साहब आप कंट्रासेप्टिव एक्स को 100 कर दो तो भी ए बी इंटू 100 ए के बराबर नहीं आता है. इसका मतलब कि कुछ न कुछ तो फर्टिलिटी रहेगी. सो दैट इज वाई द मैक्सिमम यूज ऑफ कंट्रासेप्टिव डज नॉट से दैट फर्टिलिटी विल बिकम जीरो. सो दिस इज द रियलिटी. सो स्टैटिस्टिक्स प्लेज सम रियल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द इन द सोसाइटी फॉर एनी फेनोमेनन. So this is the two regression lines. First is y on x, and second is x on y, and they passes from the mean of the data set. And one more thing, the relationship is positive or negative, it comes from the correlation. If the correlation coefficient is positive, means there is a positive relationship, then both the regression coefficient or regression coefficient of y on x and x on y are positive. So regression equation, this is the regression I have already talked. Assumption, the assumption is very much similar. So data should be continuous, and should be taken from the normal population. This is the formula for obtaining regression coefficient, and this is the intercept. So this is n, n is the number of pair of observation. I'm saying this number of pair of observation. Suppose first variable is having 10 observations, second is 8 observation. So in the first observation, you have to delete 2 observation that doesn't have x. So number of pair of observation are 8. So n, number of pair of observation, summation of xi yi minus summation of xi into summation of y, and summation of x square minus summation of x square. So this is for the b, the regression coefficient, and this is for the a. When you are able to obtain this b, put in the equation, this is y bar summation of xi upon n, you can get the a. This is another formula for obtaining regression coefficient, rxy upon, this is byx. When you are going to obtain bxy, this formula become rsx upon sy. This is the standard deviation of y. So you can get, this is the correlation coefficient, you can get this bxy. This is the intercept. So this is not much important for you because this slide is made for the statistician. So prediction, you can use regression equation for prediction. Suppose you have a data set and estimate the value of A and B. Find out a equation for a given x, you can get the value of y. So this is an x and y, compute r slope intercept regression. So this is the working rule. A is this, b is this. This is the equation for a given x. So a household that discards 0.5 pounds of plastic has approximately one person. So here again, I have discussed the importance of outliers. So if in data set, outliers are present, the regression coefficient and correlation have changed. So regression equation, uncorrelated data is this, correlated data, corrected data is this, uncorrected data. So first you have to exclude outliers and then find. So with these values, these outliers, this is the equation. And without this, this is the equation. Uncorrected data, the correlation is 0.28, and corrected data, or without these three values, the regression is this. This is the clear correct relationship between the variables. These are outliers which distort the results. So be careful when your data is full of outliers. So this is the multiple regression, means this is the extension of linear relationship. I have already told, if there are more than one variable, you can use this equation. So these multiple, as far as concerned the one variable, you can get the estimate of A and B manually. But when there are more than one variable, one independent variable, it is very difficult to get the coefficient. So we need some statistical software. So this is the various relationship, linear relationship, quadratic relationship, logarithmic relationship, exponential, power, and this is the logistic relationship. The relationship can be made. So it is linear, and these are non-linear relationship. So this is linear, this is parabolic or quadratic, This is logarithmic, exponential power, and this is logistic relation. So measure of relationship. So what type of data you should require for the Pearson correlation coefficient? Means Pearson correlation coefficient can be obtained for interval data, not for nominal and ordinal data. Rank correlation is obtained only for the rank data. Phi, another measure of association. This is available with the SPSS software. I will show you. 2x2 table means if there are two variables and both having only two category. Suppose my question is that there is a variable gender and marital status. If there is an association, you cannot obtain rank correlation and correlation of coefficient correlation. So you can use this phi to know the association between these two variables, and both the variables having only two categories. So you can make a 2x2 contingency table, and phi provide the association between two variables. Eta, nominal versus interval. So AZ marries is an interval data, and gender is what? Nominal data. So my question is that what is the relation between AZ marries and sex of the respondent? So eta is more useful to find out the relationship between these two variables. Cramer V, any n cross n table, means if you have two ordinal variables and they have n number of observation, then you can obtain Cramer V. You can obtain in this, if these are in order, you can obtain rank correlation. If they are not in order, Cramer V is good. Contingency coefficient means n plus n table or nominal data, you can get the contingency C. Goodman-Kruskal gamma, ordinal versus ordinal, ordinal versus nominal. If the variables are like this, you can get these Goodman-Kruskal gamma G for association, for knowing the association. Kendall tau, ordinal versus ordinal. So these are the various measure of association to find out the relationship between two variables. So these are the various slides. So correlation regression are little bit more complex, mathematical. So for non-statistician, these are the things which can be shared. But if they want to find out, they must use the any statistical software, because they are not good in the mathematics, so they cannot find the manually these correlation and regression. So now I would like to discuss with the statistical software how to get the regression and correlation. But before this, I'd like to invite some questions related to the correlation and regression. If you have any question related to this correlation and regression, you can ask so that I can answer you. Then I would like to switch over the Excel and SPSS to show how to get the correlation and regression. Okay, any question? Dharin, any participant have any question, then they can ask me so that I can answer.
No, sir, it seems that no one has any doubts.
No doubt.
You can continue.
So, okay. I'm sharing my Excel sheet and SPSS sheet, but it is not appear in the cancel a window. It is not appearing in this share application window. Can you help? Can you help, Dharan? It is not coming. Yeah, everybody having Excel and SPSS with their computers, I think. Okay, it is coming. So first, I'd like to share Excel sheet. So everybody seeing this Excel sheet?
Yes, sir. It is visible.
It is visible. Okay. So this Excel software is very magical software, and this is I think you can say this is the super calculator, not computer, super calculator. In each cell you can write the formula and obtain the result. Okay, suppose this is the first cell. I'm putting equal 2 into 3. This is 6. So Excel can compute 2 into 3. So suppose I am writing here 2 and the second cell is 3, and in the third cell I have written equation this into this. Again, this is 6. So what it means this cell provide the number written in the first cell and number written in the second, the product of number written in this first cell and second cell. You can drag it when you write here some values in this. This is the beauty of this software. You will get the result immediately, no need of calculation, because the formula written here is dragged. In this formula, A2 into B2, A2 into, so these basic operation, you know. I think everybody having knowledge about some calculation. So let it is, this is, suppose these are the data. Suppose let it is the data, and you want to know the average of this data. Write in this cell a program, AWS. Here, average is coming. Average. Okay. What are the number for which you want to know the average? These are the number. Click here, put it bracket, close. So the average is this. Is it clear? You want to standard deviation of these number. Standard. STDV. Numbers. So clicking here and number. So this is the standard deviation. You want to know the variance, so this to the power 2. So this is the square, this is the variance. It is very easy to compute. Okay. Now, another method, these are the data. These are the data, I want to find out the mean. So click here, summation. So summation is what? 65. And how many observations are? 9. So divided this number by 9, you'll get this number, same number. So there are some inbuilt functions you can use, or you can use the formula. I want to know the standard deviation with the formula. So these are the observation. What is the standard deviation formula? Summation of xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. Okay, variance. First you obtain the n. So this is the xi minus, this is the mean. Take it square. So put it. Okay. subtract it. But here I've written C1 minus C10, and we don't want to change this C10 in this E11. So E11 is nothing. So you should put here dollar. You don't want to change this E10. Now, after dragging this, you'll have this. Okay. So this is divided by 9. This is the sum of square of deviation. So this divided by 9. What is this? What is this? This is the variability. This is the variance. So why there is a difference? Why there is a difference? Standard deviation. Okay. SQRT. Why there is a difference? I think these are not approximated. That is why the difference is there.
Under root. The root.
Yes, yes. SQRT is I have written. This is the observation minus x bar to the square. This is the sum. This sum is divided by 9. This is the variance. Maybe a little bit different. I think this is n minus 1. Suppose. Okay. This is the result. So I'd like to show. I'd like to show this because everybody knows the sample variance and population variance. So always this Excel, the inbuilt function is made on the sample. You know the sample variance is calculated by summation of xi minus x square, sorry, x bar to the power 2 divided by n minus 1. But for population mean, it is summation of xi minus x bar to the square upon n. So that is where the result will be different. When we divide it by n minus 1, we'll get the same result. So be careful when you're using the measure of variability with this Excel software. And the measure where measure of variability is involved, like where correlation is involved, the correlation coefficient obtained with this Excel software may be different than the any statistical software like R, SPSS, or whatever another software. So my submission here to show this Excel software is that this is based, the formula inbuilt in this Excel software is based on sample, not on the population. Okay. But people, those who are not knowing a statistical software or not having any statistical software, they can use up to some extent. So there is an data analysis add-ons package is there. You can use ANOVA, correlation, covariance, descriptive statistics, exponential smoothing, regression, t-test, all these. Some basic statistics are here. So people can use. Suppose I want correlation. I want to know the correlation between. So what is input range? Input range is this, X and Y. Output range is, let output range is this. So what is the correlation? This is the correlation between column 1 and column 2 is minus 665. It may be different when you are using the method or formula for population. Is it clear? So this software can be used for some small type of analysis, but this software is useful for data presentation. So there is an graphical presentation methodologies. These are the bar chai chart. So I'm not going detail how to make bar diagram, how to make histogram. This is not possible in this webinar methodology. So you are not seeing me and I'm not seeing you. So everything cannot be possible to say. So now I would like to come with the SPSS so that you can able to obtain measure of central tendencies, measure of variabilities, and okay. So this is Excel sheet. It is visible to all. So suppose I want to find out the measure of central tendency or univariate measure and bivariate measure. So we need two variables. So suppose we have an hypothetical data. So this is not real, but this is an hypothetical data, and we want to know how to find out the various measure. So, and the second variable, okay, these are the two variables. So there is an analysis tool, descriptive statistics. So in this, in descriptive statistics, there is frequency, descriptive, explore, cross-trap, ratio, PP plot, and QQ plot. So I am discussing only frequency, how to obtain the measure of a single variables measure. So we use variable one, put the statistics. What do you want? Quartiles, okay, mean, median, mod, sum of the observation, standard deviation, maximum, minimum, standard of variance, ranges, skewness, kurtosis. Okay. There is a cut point. There is a cut point. There is a cut point and percentile. So what is this? What is this? Suppose first we want to see this. What are the, so for the first variable, this is the frequency distribution. First variable, this is the frequency distribution. All variables are coming one time except 62. And there are 10 observations. No missing is there. Mean is this. Standard error of mean is this. Median, mod, standard deviation, variances, skewness, kurtosis, standard error of skewness and kurtosis, range, maximum, minimum, sum of observation, percentile, 25th, 50th, and 75th. I have obtained quartiles. So there are three quartiles, Q1, Q2, Q3. Q2 is the median. You can see 39.5 is median, and 50th percentile is 39.5. So it is important, second quartile, fifth decile, and 50th percentile are same. In this analysis, there is a cut point. Suppose we want to know the cut point which divide data set into three part. Okay, quartile divide into whole data set into four part. Suppose I want a cut point which divide whole data set into three parts. Many time we have a data set in terms of the score and want to convert it into three category, high, low, high, moderate, low, like so, socioeconomic status. You go to the field and collect data and calculate a score for the household, and now categorize. Some are high SES, some are moderate, and some are low. So what will be the cutoff point? How can you decide? Statistically, you can decide from here. Suppose I want three categories, three equal groups. Uncheck all these. You'll get the points at which your data set divided into three equal parts. So 23.66 and 45.33 is the value which divide your data set into three equal parts. So it is the beauty of this methodology to obtain a particular value. Now you can change. This is hard and this is not an hard and fast that we should use this particular value. You can change. You can change and take some adjacent value to divide or make the boundary. So in this way, you can get the all measure of central tendency, measure of variability, and measure of skewness and kurtosis. Now this is the descriptive. So what is descriptive measures? So in option, you can see mean, sum, standard deviation, minimum, variance. So some are some of the character available here. But in the previous one, all measure of variability, measure of skewness, kurtosis, and measure of central tendency available with the previous analysis tool. But in analysis tool, some are. So let it be how to get kurtosis. So it is here. So in this way, this comes. In the previous step, you will get this frequency table also. But in this frequency table is not there. But the values are very, very much same. Values are very much same. Is it not or no? Yeah. Okay. Now, crosstab. This crosstab is used for bivariate table. Let in row variable one and in this. There are some statistics. First, this table is there. Means this is the bivariate table and some bivariate tables, there are some statistical measures. So this is exact. This is not useful for non-statistician. This is statistics is there. What measure of relation I have discussed, they are here. Ordinal, nominal, and nominal versus interval, they are even. You can get the kappa value, that is for the reliability. When people are knowing whether our data is reliable or not, they can use kappa. Risk, this is, suppose you are using dichotomous data, you can get the risk. And some tests are there, but they are not very much useful for non-statistician. Chi-square can obtain here, correlation can obtain here, but with the chi-square statistics, there is a drawback with this statistical software. This statistical software never merges the column or row that have frequency, expected frequency less than 5. So you should find out this chi-square manually. This, we cannot believe and the chi-square in this software because of this drawback. You can obtain the percentage from here, row-wise percentage, column-wise percentage, expected frequencies you can get from here. So these are facilities given in this statistical software, SPSS, so you can obtain. Now, the correlation and regression. So correlation is given here, correlate, bivariate. So there are two variables, and we want to correlation between these variables. So you can click here. Pearson Condell tau and Spearman rank correlation is given. So I click all these. If you want Pearson, you can uncheck these two. So this is the correlation coefficient between 2.870. It is not same as the Excel, because in Excel, in denominator, n minus 1 is used in place of n. That Excel software is used sample variance formula. However, this SPSS software use population variance formula. This is the Condell tau and Spearman rank correlation is obtained here. And there is testing, t-test for the correlation coefficient. It is given, and it is not significant here also. So now we come at the regression. You can get the regression here from here, linear correlation. So dependent, suppose variable 2 is depending on variable 1, you can put it here and click here. You will get the regression coefficient. So this is the ANOVA table, and this is the model summary, R square. The correlation of, this is known as sometimes correlation determinants coefficient of determination. And this coefficient of determination tell about how much explanation available with this model, okay? Or you can say how much your independent variable explains dependent variable. So the for default, for this hypothetical data, it is 0.75, means the variable 2, variable 1 have 75% or almost 76% capacity to explain variable 2. So the coefficient of variable 2 is 0.533, and this is the intercept, 15.51. So the equation become what? Y is equal to 0.533 variable into variable 1 plus 15.51. So with this way, you can...
Sir, sorry for intervening, but the output file is not visible.
Output file is not visible. So how will it... Output file is not... How can I make it visible? One second, I'll try.
Yes, sir.
I'll try to make it visible. हर चीज इसमें यही है ना कि वेबिनार में हर चीज नहीं हो पाता है कभी कभी. एक सेकंड, आई एम स्टॉपिंग दिस. ओके प्रेजेंट नाउ. यस, नाउ इट इज विजिबल.
यस सर, नाउ इट इज विजिबल.
Okay. So from beginning, I have discussed. So when this is analysis tool, it is visible, na? ये दिखाई पड़ रहा है भाई?
Yes, sir, दिख रहा है.
Okay. तो आप descriptive statistics में जाके frequency use करके आप कोई भी variable को देके statistic में यहाँ जा करके आप choose कर सकते हैं. जो भी आपको चाहिए आप ले लीजिए. हमने चूज किया सब, ये आया, ये फ्रीक्वेंसी टेबल हुआ. डिस्क्रिप्टिव में करेंगे तो कुछ इस तरीके से आ जाएगा, इस तरह से. कोरिलेशन निकालेंगे, ये आएगा. ये कोरिलेशन क्या बता रहा है? पियर्सन कोरिलेशन, वेरिएबल वन का वेरिएबल वन के बीच में वन ही होगा. सेम वेरिएबल में अगर करोगे तो आपको परफेक्ट मिलेगा. वेरिएबल वन वेरिएबल टू से करेंगे 0.872 है. इस हाइपोथेटिकल डेटा के लिए जो भी डेटा हमने लिया, ठीक है, वेरिएबल टू का वेरिएबल वन से रिलेशन 0.87 है. अब हमारे पास आता है कि नहीं, कोई नॉन पैरामेट्रिक कोरिलेशन है, नॉन लीनियर कोरिलेशन है, तो ये हम निकाल लिए. इसका भी प्रोविजन है, आप क्लिक करके निकाल सकते हैं. यहाँ से एनालिसिस में जाएंगे, कोरिलेशन में, बाइवेरिएट कोरिलेशन में आप जाएंगे. आपके पास ये तीन चीजें पड़ी हुई हैं, आप अनचेक कर सकते हैं या जिसको चाहिए उसको चेक कर लीजिए. ठीक है, Now regression. रेग्रेशन का आउटपुट ये आया, कैसे आया? रेग्रेशन में आप जाएंगे, लीनियर रेग्रेशन आपको निकालना है। यहाँ पे बहुत सारे प्रोविजन है, नॉन लीनियर कोरिलेशन, बाइवेरेट लॉजिस्टिक कोरिलेशन, मल्टीनोमियल लॉजिस्टिक कोरिलेशन, ऑर्डिनल प्रॉफिट, बहुत सारे हैं, नॉन लीनियर और भी हैं, पॉइसन रेग्रेशन, वेटेड एस्टिमेशन, कुछ भी निकाल सकते हैं। बट लीनियर कोरिलेशन की बात हम यहाँ कर रहे थे। तो वेरिएबल टू को हमने डिपेंडेंट माना, वेरिएबल वन को इंडिपेंडेंट माना, एंड नाउ वी क्लिक ओके एंड विल गेट दिस output. So model summary R, this R is what? This is the multiple relation, multiple correlation, but here only one variable has been used, so that this capital R is equal to small r. This is the representation of multiple correlation. Capital R represented multiple correlation, small r linear correlation. So this is same as the linear correlation what we have obtained. R square, capital R square means this is the coefficient of determination. This provide the idea about the explanation of the model, how much our model has capacity to explain dependent variable. So here it is 0.758, it is 0.758 means 76% capability available in the model to explain dependent variable, means variable 1 explain variable 2 at 76%. Is it? This is the ANOVA table. This is the ANOVA table calculated on the basis of this data set, and this regression is significant. This p-value said that it is significant, and this is the regression coefficient. This is the slope of the model, and this is the intercept of the model. Means this is constant. Constant means A, and this is the B. So what is the equation? What is the equation for this? Variable 2 is equal to 0.533 into variable 1 plus 15.519. This is the equation. And for what value of 1 you want to get the variable of 2? Suppose variable 1 is equal to 20. Multiply 20 with 0.533 plus and add this much value, you'll get the expected value of variable 2. So this is what how to get the regression and correlation with the statistical software. There are much more have to discuss, but there is a time limitation in the any seminar discussion. So if anybody have some specific question, they can contact with the any person, those who know the statistics. So if you have any question, then you can ask. Anybody have any question?
I request all the participants.
Yes, sir, I'm having one question.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, sir.
This is Arpit. Sir, I am having one question. Sir, actually, if I am having 4 dependent variables and 4 independent variables at that point of time, which type of regression and correlation I should use?
Okay. Four independent variable and four.
For example,
dependent four variables. Independent and how much dependent variable? As far as correlation is, there is no dependent variable and independent variable. There is variable. Pair of observations should be there. Whatever you have variable is there. You can obtain the correlation. But when you want to get the regression,
you
can decide dependent variable and independent variable. Suppose there is a dependent variable and you want to get the effect of sum of variables, then you can put in the formula. If you see this SPSS window, you are seeing this SPSS window?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So suppose there are 2-3
At present, sir, SPSS window is not visible.
It is not visible. Okay. It is visible. It is visible?
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is visible. So suppose there are three variables. I'm some values here. 52. There are three variables, and we want to get the impact of variable one and variable two on variable three. Okay, so variable three is the dependent variable, and yes, we want to know the impact of variable one and variable two. So this is the independent variable column. So you can put many. If you have 10, 20, they come into this. But there is a dependent variable. There is only one dependent variable.
Okay.
So put here, drag and drop. You can click here and drop here. In this statistics, you can get the estimate, confidence interval, all these things. Okay, you can change this level of confidence and put it compute. You can get the plot also. So many things are there. All these things cannot cover in a short time. So this is this. So this is the constant A, and these are the coefficient of variables. Is it clear?
Yes.
So you can get.
Yes.
But one more thing is, if you have more than one dependent variable and more than one dependent variable, then this regression cannot help you. So some multivariate techniques are there, factor analysis and some canonical analysis, principal component analysis are there. They can be used. But in regression techniques, only one.
Which type of techniques are I can use?
Yes. Pardon?
Hello. Sir, I was asking, which type of technique I should use? For example, I am having four dependent and three independent variables.
Okay.
So if I am considering in this type of regression, one dependent and all the four, I will not use this type of technique?
I am asking, if you have one dependent variable, so models are decided at the brain level. Model cannot be extracted with this software.
Yes.
Suppose you want to know a combination of the impact of combination of independent variable on a particular dependent variable, then this regression can help. Is it? But when you want to know a combination of independent variable, the effect of combination of independent variable on combination of dependent variable, then this technique cannot help you. You need multivariate analysis. Multivariable and multivariate analysis, there is a different. This is multivariable analysis. There is only one dependent variable. But in multivariate analysis, there may be more than one variable. But the techniques for analyzing multivariate analysis are limited, and they are very much complicated. And the assumption should be very clear before using this multivariate techniques. So for this multivariate technique, there are principal component analysis, factor analysis, cluster analysis, canonical analysis are available. They are available with these softwares, and you can use after knowing the technicalities of these techniques. Any other?
Okay, sir. And sir, what is the standard R value which describes the variability of the variable?
Okay. So, I don't know. There is a standard R. I think there is R, multiple correlation. R square, that is the coefficient of determination, and adjusted R square. These three are there. I don't know if standard R is.
Yes, sir. I am asking for R square. I am asking for what is the standard value of R square that is considerable.
No. We cannot have any standard value like T value. You know, if the multivariable analysis, many time the value of R square is low, but the model is very useful. The coefficient are very useful. It should be more. It should be more for a multivariate analysis, multivariable analysis. This is simply the square of multiple correlation. Is it clear? So never we can get
it. Sir, is I was asking for single variable.
Single variable it is when
I was asking for single variable analysis.
Single variable analysis, the R square, na? R square ke liye?
Yes sir.
First you understand the capital R. What is capital R? Capital R is multiple correlation coefficient.
Yes sir.
When independent variable is only one and dependent variable is only one, this multiple correlation coefficient is nothing but correlation coefficient. And R square is what? The square of correlation coefficient. And R square, the range of R square is 0 to 1. The value of R square is expected to be very close to 1 for a good model. Is it clear? This is clear what I am saying?
Exactly, sir.
Okay. So for, yes, sir, for as far as one variable, it should be close to 1 for a good model. And what is the explanation of this R square? This is the capacity of explaining the model. Suppose here the screen which is shown to you, the R square is 0.089, means the combination of variable 1 and variable 2 explain variable 3 at what? 8.9%, means only 9% explanation is there. It is very poor. But in the previous analysis, it is 0.76, where one variable is there. Means that particular one variable explain variable 2 at 75 or 76%. So always you will get the multiple correlation very less. And the square of this multiple correlation is again very less because it is less than 1. So in case of multiple variables, this R square is very less. So it is very less. You see the variables coefficient, whether they are significant. If they are significant, you can take. Your model capacity is this much. But what is the coefficient of regression? It is also important. So both are important. You can take the decision whether our model is good or our effect is good. So there is nothing standard value. It is lying between 0 and 1.
Okay.
But general perception is that it should be close to 1.
So you mean to say if R square value is less?
No.
I
don't think
but your submission is if R square value is less, we should see the significance value and the correlation value.
My question is that when you are seeing this model summary, R square is coming at 10%. Our model capacity is only 10% to explain the dependent variable. But in the model, what are the coefficient of variables? If the coefficient of variables are good to explain, then we can take. If the variables are insignificant, then we discard the model. Suppose my model explains 70%. Suppose my model explains 70%. And in model, there are 5 independent variables. Only one independent variable having coefficient which is significant. All other 4 are not significant. Should we consider this model? No. Bhai, aisa model,
no.
Jo bata raha hai ki nahi 70% explain kar rahe hain. Usme 4 independent variable humne liya hai. Ek hi independent variable significant hai. Baki ke 3 nahi hai. To behtar hoga ki hum baki ke 3 ko hata de. Unka koi matlab hi nahi hai. Sara ka sara domination kahan pe hai? Ek hi variable ke saath hai na? मॉडल को डिसाइड करने में हमको अपना भी विवेक का इस्तेमाल करना पड़ेगा. ये नहीं कि हाँ जो इससे आगे स्पेसेस से वही करेंगे, इसलिए थोड़ा सा पार्शियल कोरिलेशन और मल्टीपल कोरिलेशन के बारे में भी जानना इम्पोर्टेंट. यस
ओके, इम्पोर्टेंट ये है कि आप एक सिग्निफिकेंस वैल्यू देख ले, अगर वो सिग्निफिकेंट है तो हम उसको कंसिडर करें, हाँ. नहीं है तो उसको रिमूव करें.
नहीं, जब सिग्निफिकेंट नहीं है तो उसको हटा सकते हैं ना. इसीलिए मैंने आपको कहा कि जब भी आप मल्टीपल कोरिलेशन और पार्शियल कोरिलेशन की बात करते हैं तो ये चीजें बहुत जरूरी हो जाती हैं. जब कई वेरिएबल हम यूज करते हैं तो पार्शियल कोरिलेशन भी काम करता है. तो दोज हु आर डोमिनेटिंग कैरेक्टर्स वेरिएबल, डोमिनेटिंग नेचर वेरिएबल्स, दे कैन अपीयर विद हाई कोरिलेशन. तो जो लेस सिग्निफिकेंट है या सिग्निफिकेंट नहीं है उनको आप हटा दीजिए, फिर मॉडल को डिसाइड करिए. तो सारा सारा खेल जो मॉडलिंग का है वो हमारे मतलब कि हमको सोच लेना है पहले से कि हमें क्या करना है. ये तो डेटा डेटा को कैलकुलेट कर रहा है ना. एसपीएसएस सॉफ्टवेयर या कोई भी स्टैटिस्टिकल सॉफ्टवेयर डेटा से फाइंडिंग ले आते हैं, लेकिन मॉडल तो हमको अपने दिमागी स्तर पे बनाना है ना कि क्या एक्सप्लेनेशन होगा. और कोई चीज पूछनी?
थैंक यू सर.
और कोई चीज किसी को पूछनी है तो पूछिए भाई.
यस सर. सर आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन सर. गुड आफ्टरनून सर. मेरा क्वेश्चन है कि सर अगर मेरा एक्सेल में ही डाटा एनालिसिस हो जाता है तो क्या मुझे एसपीएसएस का यूज करना चाहिए?
देखिए मैंने पहले ही बताया कि एसपीएसएस एक स्टैटिस्टिकल सॉफ्टवेयर है, सोशल साइंटिस्ट को बनाया गया है, और एक्सेल में डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैटिस्टिक्स में मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी तो सही है, क्योंकि मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी जब आप निकालते हो तो सैंपल और पॉपुलेशन दोनों के फार्मूला एक ही होते हैं. लेकिन वेरिएबिलिटी का सैंपल वेरिएंस का फार्मूला अलग है, पॉपुलेशन वेरिएंस का फार्मूला अलग है. अलग क्या उसमें है? डिनोमिनेटर में एक में एन होता है पॉपुलेशन में, सैंपल में एन माइनस वन होता है. हमने पहले कैलकुलेट करके दिखाया ना, इनबिल्ट फंक्शन लिया तो कुछ है, हमने फार्मूला लिखा जो हम पॉपुलेशन के लिए जानते हैं तो अलग है, फिर हमने एन माइनस वन किया तो सेम मिल गया. तो अगर वेरिएबिलिटी के मेजर और कुछ चीजें आप निकालना चाहते हैं तो वो सैंपल वेरिएबिलिटी पे काम करता है. इसलिए कभी भी एक्सेल को हम लोग स्टैटिस्टिकल सॉफ्टवेयर नहीं कहते. जब भी आप कंपेयर करेंगे स्टैटिस्टिकल सॉफ्टवेयर से और एक्सेल के आउटपुट में तो थोड़ा बहुत अंतर आता है. तो अगर आपको स्टैटिस्टिक्स आती है और स्टैटिस्टिकल सॉफ्टवेयर कोई ऑपरेट करना आता है तो बेटर शुड यूज स्टैटिस्टिकल सॉफ्टवेयर. एक्सेल इज सुपर कैलकुलेटर. अगर कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है आपके पास तो आप एक्सेल से काम चला लीजिए. और कोई चीज किसी को पूछनी है मेरे लेक्चर को जो मुझे असाइन किया गया था उसमें?
I think all the queries has been resolved.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for such a fruitful session. We are highly obliged to have you in the session.
Thank you.
Now we have reached at the end of the session, and I request Professor G.N. Sharma, Head and Dean of Department of Applied Economics and Commerce, to propose vote of thanks. Sir, please. Dharen sir, the G.N. Sharma sir's mic is muted. Please unmute it.
So mic aapke end pe unmute hoga sir. Sir mic ko unmute kar lijiye. माइक को अनम्यूट कर लीजिए सर. सर माइक आपके एंड पे म्यूटेड है सर, उसको अनम्यूट कर लीजिए।
I think GL Sharma sir is disconnected from the meeting.
He is joining the meeting soon. We will present the vote of thanks. We will wait for some seconds.
हेलो
हाँ सर, आपकी आवाज आ रही है।
आ रही आवाज,
कंटिन्यू करें सर। हाँ सर, कंटिन्यू करें सर।
आवाज आ रही है?
यस सर।
हाँ हाँ ठीक, चलिए। संध्या सत्र में शवों को अभिवादन करता हूँ, नमन करता हूँ, साधुवाद देता हूँ। हाँ, आज इस सत्र के आकर्षक बिंदु रहे हमारे ब्रजेश प्रसाद सिंह जी, आपको हृदय से बहुत बहुत साधुवाद। आपने जिस सब्जेक्ट को लेकर के आज हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स के बीच में उतरे हैं, मैं कुछ देरी के लिए खो गया जब मैं पटना यूनिवर्सिटी में पढ़ता था। बात 1980 की दशक का है, जब मैं क्लास में विद्यार्थी होता था एमकॉम का, और हमारे साहब है राम जी ये पेपर लेकर के आते थे पढ़ाने के लिए। आज मैं जिस तरह से सरल सूत्रों में आपका देख रहा था पेपर, मैं अपने अतीत में खो गया था कुछ देर के लिए। ब्रजेश प्रसाद जी, आपकी इतनी सरल ढंग से प्रस्तुतिकरण के लिए हम कोटि कोटि धन्यवाद आपको अर्पित करते हैं। आज के सत्र के अंतिम दौर तक इतनी उपस्थिति बनी रहनी इस बात का द्योतक है कि बहुत सरल भाव में, सरल सुझाव में आपने जो परोसा है यह पेपर को शबों के लिए, ये सर्वग्राह्य हुआ। मैं कहा ना कि जब हम लोग पढ़ते थे एमकॉम में, उस समय साहब है राम जी पटना यूनिवर्सिटी के जाने माने प्रोफेसर हुआ करते थे, लेकिन उनकी क्लास से लड़के भाग खड़े होते थे। कुछ हम लोग जो आगे बेंच पर बैठते थे, जाने पहचाने थे, जिनके चेहरा उनकी उपस्थिति देना जरूरी हो जाती थी, सो दैट हम लोग इसको सीखते थे। आज पुनः हमको याद आ गया आपके यह लेक्चर से कि आपने जिस तरह से इतना देर तक क्वेश्चन के लिए आपने इंतजार किया, हम कहने जा रहे थे बीच में, कि नहीं क्वेश्चन ज्यादा उठना, बस समझिए कि सब लोगों के लिए सहज सुपाच्य है, सहज सुपाच्य है। अदरवाइज हम लोग के क्लास में देखते थे कि बच्चे बोला करते थे कि सर अब आप ही क्वेश्चन है, आप ही जवाब है, इसका मतलब क्या है, इसका मतलब कि हम नहीं समझ पा रहे। लेकिन रियली में आज हमारे प्रतिभागियों के लिए आपने जो यह ज्ञान गंगा का अविरल सूत्र प्रदान किया है, जिसे हमारे सभी पार्टिसिपेट लगातार में भी संख्या गिन रहा था कि अभी लास्ट सत्र में, अंतिम सत्र में, संध्या के सत्र में हमारे बच्चों का इतना उपस्थिति बना रहना ये कोई खेल बात नहीं है। सब लोगों ने इसको स्वीकारा आपके क्लास पर। जय जय है सर ब्रजेश प्रसाद जी, आपको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। और पुनः मैं आग्रह करूंगा, चूंकि हमारे यहाँ अब लगातार इस तरह के कार्यक्रम की जब शुरुआत हुई है तो बंद नहीं होने जा रहा है, और जब तक मैं विभागाध्यक्ष हूँ तब तक तो एकदम नहीं, और तब तक हमारे पांडे जो सहायक शिक्षक हैं तब तक तो ये बहुत ऊंचाई हासिल कर लेंगे। आप लोग का ब्लेसिंग साथ चाहिए, और हमारा बस यह जो एसोसिएशन मिला है इंडियन अकाउंटिंग एसोसिएशन, जिंदाबाद है सर, कि हर प्रॉब्लम में हमारे साथ खड़ा हो जाएगा और हम हर कार्य को आगे करके ले चलेंगे, दिखलाएंगे। बस आप जैसे विद्वत जनों से सर्वदा प्रार्थना होगी कि जब भी कभी शॉर्ट नोटिस जाएगी, कभी पहले भी, जैसे अभी और हम लोग का प्रोग्राम अभी शुरू होने वाला है सर जी, तो हम लोग अभी वही विचार मंथन में थे। एनीवे जब भी हो आपका सहयोग की मैं अपेक्षा करता हूँ, और या तो थोड़ा सा टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम हो जाता है ऑनलाइन में, लेकिन जिस समय आप क्लास में आएंगे, हमारे विद्यार्थियों के बीच में आएंगे, विद्यार्थियों को दुगनी शक्ति बढ़ जाएगी। बहुत सारे टेक्निकल फॉल्ट की वजह से लोग कुछ मिस करते हैं, लेकिन हम विश करते हैं कि आप इसी तरह से एकदम आप लंद से हम लोगों को कुछ न कुछ देते रहे। आज की केंद्र बिंदु में हमारे यहाँ जितने जो है पार्टिसिपेंट्स रहे, सबों को हृदय से एक बार स्वागत करता हूँ, और इसी तरह की उपस्थिति अभी लगातार हमारा 5-7 दिन जो भी चलना है कार्यक्रम, उसमें सब बनाए रहे। नूपुर जी को विशेष धन्यवाद, जो आपने रह रह के गति को तेज किया है, नहीं तो कभी कभी वक्ता अपने अपने बकते बकते सो जाते हैं, ऐसा मैंने बहुतों देखा अपने जीवन काल में। क्यों? क्योंकि उनको कोई पूछने वाला नहीं होता है, वो चाहते हैं कि हमसे कोई कुछ प्रश्न पूछे, सो दैट हम उनको जितना जानते हैं बताने की कोशिश करें। इस कड़ी में आप लोगों से उठाए गए प्रश्न आप लोग को रह रह के कुछ सूत्र पर धुआंधार जो है से चर्चा करवाने के लिए आपने उत्तेजना पैदा कर दिया है, इसके लिए आपको भी धन्यवाद, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। नूपुर जी आप इसी तरह के कार्यक्रम को तीव्र गति प्रदान करते रहे। इन्हीं सारे शब्दों के साथ मैं आज संध्या काल के सत्र को विदाई करता हूँ, धन्यवाद सबको देता हूँ। इस तरह के कार्यक्रम को सफल बनाने में आपका जो है अटूट सहयोग रहा, इस सहयोग के लिए हमारा सारा परिवार जो है वो आभारी है, और इंडियन अकाउंटिंग एसोसिएशन परिवार जो लगातार करने के लिए साहस फूका है, इसको हम जो है से उतार रहे हैं धीरे धीरे, एक एक करके सारी गतिविधियों से हम परिचित करा रहे हैं बच्चों को। चूंकि बच्चे के फील्ड में हम हैं, हम सबों को चाहेंगे जितना मैक्सिमम हो सबों को लाभ मिलता रहे। धन्यवाद, बहुत बहुत बधाई हो आप लोग को, या आप आए ये और आ करके हमारे इस कार्यक्रम को सफल बनाते जा रहे हैं, और आगे दूसरी शक्ति से फिर मैं पांडे को ललकारा हूं कि अब आगे बढ़ो, और आगे बढ़ करके फिर जो है से अब तो कल की पुनः तैयारी करनी है। लेकिन ब्रजेश जी आपकी आज का वो जसवी जो लेक्चर जो हुआ, जिस तरह से कठिन शब्दों को सरल शब्दों में परोस के दिखाया है, बस इस कला को मैं एक बार फिर चाहूंगा समय आने के बाद एकदम खुले मंच से आ करके
आएंगे।
आप आएंगे और आ करके इस
आएंगे सर, हम आएंगे सर, हमें बिहार से बहुत मोहब्बत है।
हाँ बस इस मोहब्बत को टूटना नहीं चाहिए ब्रजेश जी, बस मोहब्बत
आपको मैंने ये बहुत अपना पसंदीदा छात्र दिया है
जी जी, बस इस छात्र पर गर्व है। और छात्र इसलिए तो कह रहा है कि जब मैं सेवा मुक्त होऊंगा पूरे इस पर जो है से हमारी जो है से कमांड रहेगा, क्योंकि कुछ दिन तक तो हमको और साथ इनको निभाना है, चलना है, बहुत दूर तक इनको जो है से जाना है। और उस यात्रा में जब तक हम थकते नहीं है, उबते नहीं है, तब तक मैं चलता रहता हूँ और चलूंगा, ये मैं विश्वास दिलाता हूँ। और अभी बहुत कुछ कार्यक्रम है करने, इसलिए आज बस इतने शब्दों के साथ आपके लिए जो भी शब्द होंगे वो सब छोटे पड़ेंगे, क्योंकि आप जिस तरह से आप लोग महान हस्तियां हैं, जहां भी जाएंगे वहां अपना जो है से कीर्ति दिखला देते हैं। आपके जो है से सहज भाव, सहज स्वरूप सचमुच में बरबस मोह ले रहा है, अट्रैक्शन का बिंदु है आज। आज हमारे कार्यक्रम में सब चार चांद लगाए, इस कार्यक्रम को सफल बनाए, इसलिए इस सफलता के लिए आप लोगों को कोटि कोटि धन्यवाद। धन्यवाद सर,
थैंक यू सो मच सर, थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर योर पार्टिसिपेशन। प्लीज डू कम फॉर टुमारो सेशन बिफोर टाइम, स्टे होम स्टे सेफ, थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू नूपुर जी, थैंक यू धरन,
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर।